Welcome back for another weekly newscast DHS. We're going to mix things up this week and start with sports. It's been a busy week here at the high school as Doniphan has played the host for the Ozark Foothill Conference Tournament this week. We've seen a total of 18 basketball games in 5 days and lots of fans from all over Southeast Missouri coming to cheer on their teams. It all started Saturday with 9 games. The Donettes had the third seed in the tournament and played in the first round against East Carter. After a slow start in the first half, the Donettes opened up their lead in the second half and ended up winning that game by a score of 47-31. In the second round, the girls faced Naylor and went into halftime only down by 6. However, the Lady Eagles stretched their lead in the second half and ended up winning 48-31. The Donettes played the third place in the tournament last night. Here's a score of that game. On the boys' side, the Dons had the second seed in the tournament and played East Carter in the first round Saturday night. The Dons also started off slow in the first quarter, only scoring 11. But after they found their groove, they cruised to the victory over the Redbirds 85-29. In the second round Tuesday night, they played the third seed Neelyville Tigers, which was a back and forth game through 3 quarters. But the Donettes pulled away late in the game behind Clay Barton's 39 points and ended up winning 89-79. The Dons will play tonight at Three Rivers College in a championship game against the top seed Twin Rivers at 8:30. The JV boys will also be playing tonight at 5:30 against East Carter. Good luck to both teams. And next week is the final week of the regular season. The Dons have 1 game left, and that is here at home Tuesday night against Eminence. The Donettes will play Monday at Hayside and then Friday at Crothersville. One last note in sports. The baseball team will be holding tryouts on Monday, the 27th, and Tuesday, the 28th. Anyone who is interested in playing for the team will need to meet at the field after school each day. Here's Gage with more news and announcements.
Thanks, Jared. Another place that is going to be busy all next week is the Career Center. All week long, students from 6 schools will come to tour the programs there and see what the Career Center has to offer. Sophomores, you will tour the school on Monday morning during the second and third periods. It will also be a short week next week. Parent-teacher night will be held Thursday night, which means we get out at 12:30 Thursday and that there will be no school on Friday. Progress reports for the third quarter will be handed out at the high school from 3 to 8. We have the results of the canned food drive that was held last week as part of the Super Bowl caring. The elementary school collected the most cans with a little more than 2,400. The middle school came in second with 601 and the high school 461. The classes that collected the most in each building were Mrs. Ritter's, Mrs. Folks, and Mr. Pennington's. Key Club's Trivia Night is coming up next Friday, and there is still time to get a team into the competition if you would like. There are 6 players per team, and it does cost $10 per player to enter. See Mr. Pennington if you have any questions. Our rep from SEMA will be here on March 13th to speak to any interested students. If you are interested, sign up in the counseling office. And finally, there is still time to order a yearbook if you would like one. They are up to $50, and orders will be taken up until April 28th. See any yearbook staff member or Mr. Donnell if you would like to order one. And now, here's Aaron Castile with the weather.
Thanks, Gage, and another really warm weekend coming up. Tomorrow will be mostly cloudy with a high near 70. Sunday, a chance of thunderstorms and a high of 63. Then on Monday, partly sunny and a high of 50. And that's our newscast for this week. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again in 2 weeks.